Hi children, welcome to the lesson. Today we are going to know about diffusion. Look here, we are going to observe the diffusion of gases, liquids and solids. Today we are going to observe the diffusion of gases, liquids and solids. Observe the images carefully. Think about the images. Let us observe the diffusion of gases. When we light the intense stick, the scent in the vapor form and smoke mixes with air and moves across the room and reach our nose. Look here, the smoke mixes with air and moves across the room and reach our nose. Once again observe this. The movement of air, vapors of scent, smoke from one place to other is known as diffusion. The movement of air, vapors of scent and smoke from one place to another is known as diffusion. In this case, smoke, vapor of scent and air are gases and are highly mobile. That means they are easily movable. Observe the smoke carefully. It is transferring from one place to another. This is known as diffusion. If you spray a perfume or deodorant in one corner of the room, it spreads soon to all directions. That means the gases move from one place to another. This is called diffusion. Now let us observe the diffusion of liquids. In liquids, we are going to observe the diffusion of liquids. In liquids, take some water in a container, use a dropper and put a few drops of potassium permanganate solution slowly along the side of container and observe. See this activity. First of all, we have to prepare potassium permanganate solution. Now we are taking 2 ml of water. In this way, we have to prepare potassium permanganate solution. So, to prepare potassium permanganate solution, we are going to take 10 ml of water. It is not necessary that to take 10 ml, but here we are taking 10 ml of potassium permanganate, 10 ml of water, and we are adding some potassium permanganate crystals to that water to make the potassium permanganate solution. Observe carefully. We are adding some crystals of potassium permanganate to the 10 ml of water. Now potassium permanganate solution is ready. Now by using a dropper, we are dropping potassium permanganate solution. Look here, what is happening? Observe it carefully. What do you observe after adding the drop of potassium permanganate? Can you observe that liquids also diffuse into each other like gases? How much time does it take the color to spread evenly throughout water? What do you conclude from this activity? Observe the liquid. Is it diffuse throughout the water? From this activity, we can conclude that liquids also diffuse in liquids, but the time taken to diffuse is much more than gases. Observe once again. After adding the potassium permanganate solution, that potassium permanganate is evenly spread throughout the water. From this, we can conclude that liquids also diffuse in liquids. The time taken to diffuse is much more than the gas. Let us see another activity. Let us observe the diffusion of solids into liquids. Look here, we have to take a beaker full of water and add a few crystals of potassium permanganate to it and observe the changes. Look here, what happened? The potassium permanganate crystals dissolved in water and spread throughout the water. Observe carefully, the potassium permanganate crystals dissolved in water and spread evenly into the water. It is clear that solids and liquids diffuse in liquids and gases diffuse into gases. Let us see a lab activity to observe the diffusion of two gases. Our aim is that to observe the speed of diffusion of two gases. For this activity, we require long glass tube like this. Look it in the picture. And liquid ammonia, HCl solution, and pieces of cotton, two rubber corks, and pair of tongs. Let us see the procedure. Diffusion of ammonia and HCl gases. Take a 1 meter long narrow glass tube. Take two pieces of cotton, soak one in HCl and another in ammonia solution. Insert them separately at the two ends of this glass tube with the help of tongs. Look here, after inserting HCl cotton immediately we have to close the tube with rubber cap. And again, after inserting HCl, we have to insert another piece of cotton which is soaked in ammonia solution at the other end of the glass tube, like this. Here also immediately close the end with rubber cork and observe. Both gases react together to form a white fumes of ammonium chloride. Look here, ammonium chloride is formed. Observe the white ring in the tube due to formation of ammonium chloride. It is nearer to HCl. Ammonium chloride, NH4Cl, is formed. Here the distance between this ammonium chloride and HCl is less than the distance between ammonia and NH4Cl. By this activity, we can say that ammonia is lighter than HCl and diffuses faster. You must take care while doing this lab activity. Look here, HCl and ammonia reacted and NH4Cl is formed. Ammonia diffuses faster than HCl. Let us see how small are the particles of matter. The materials required for this activity are 5 beakers, a stirrer to mix the solution, some water, potassium permanganate crystals, that means KMnO4 crystals, and lastly we want a syringe. First of all, we have to gather all the materials required. After gathering these material, let us do the activity. Shall we start? Look here, these are the potassium permanganate crystals, and we have to arrange 5 beakers, and each beaker contain 90 ml of water except first beaker. First beaker contain 100 ml of water, and now we have to add some crystals to the first beaker. We have to stir the beaker very well. Look here, observe the color of the solution. We have added potassium permanganate crystals. The color of the solution is thick pink. Now, by using a syringe, we have to take 10 ml of solution. Look here, in this way, we have to collect 10 ml of solution, and now add the solution to the second beaker. which contains 90 ml of water. Now, observe carefully the color of the solution. We have added 10 ml of solution. Again, stir well. Now, again we have to take 10 ml of this solution and pour it in the third beaker. It is also having 90 ml of water. Let us see the color of this solution. Again stir well. Observe the difference in the color. Now we have to take 10 ml of solution from the third beaker. Look here, we are taking 10 ml and add this to the fourth beaker. Wow, observe the color. The solution is, look here, again we are taking 10 ml of solution and adding it to the fifth beaker. Now observe the color of the solution. Observe 5 beakers. And what happened? We conclude that there must be several tiny particles in just one crystal of potassium permanganate, which are uniformly distributed in water to change its color. Do you understand? Every matter is having small, that is tiny particles. Let us see an activity that there exists space between particles. Take a beaker and fill it with some water and mark the water level. Look here. In this way we have to fill some water in a beaker. Here in this beaker the water level is 175 ml and we are taking some sugar crystals. Look here again, the level is 175 ml and we are taking some sugar crystals, that is solid particles. Add these crystals to the water and after adding we have to stir it well to dissolve the sugar crystals. Observe carefully. Now we are adding sugar crystals. Now what we have to do? We have to stir it thoroughly with a glass rod. Observe if there is any change in water level. Observe carefully. After completely dissolving sugar crystals, we have to observe the level of the water. See here, all the crystals are dissolved. Now we have to observe the water level. Look here, the water level is not increasing. Now also the water level is 175 ml. Does the level of water change? It is not changed. Where did the sugar go? Can you see it in the water? No, we are not able to see in the water. What happened to those crystals? They are dissolved. Means we can conclude that liquid particles have some space between them, and the solid particles enter into the space between the liquid particles on dissolving in liquid. Let us see an activity to show that the particles of matter attract each other. Observe the force of attraction between the particles of matter. Like here, open a water tap and allow the water to reach the ground. Now, try to break the stream of water with our finger. Look here. Can we break the stream permanently? Is it possible? Are we able to break the stream of water anywhere from the tap to the ground? Observe once again. Observe carefully. What is the reason behind the stream of water remaining together? Are we able to break the stream? You also try this activity. Let us see how diffusion takes place. We have already seen several activities to understand diffusion of particles of solids, liquids, and gases. Diffusion is possible only when the particles of matter move continuously. If the particles of matter move continuously, then only the diffusion is possible. Otherwise, it is not possible. Look at the images. We have already seen the activities about this diffusion. In the incensistic activity, the particles of scent enter the space between the air particles. The scent particles quickly spread across the room. From that activity, we know that the diffusion is greater in gases. Particles of solids, liquids, and gases can diffuse into liquids and gases. Rate of diffusion of gases is higher than the liquids, while the rate of diffusion of liquids is higher than solids. That means the rate of diffusion in gases is higher than liquids and solids. There are two reasons for higher rate of diffusion of gases. First one is speed of gas particles is very high, and also the space between gas particles is also very high. That means the distance between the particles is very, very high, higher than liquids and solids. So, the rate of diffusion in gases is higher. than liquids and solids. Similarly, the rate of diffusion in liquids is greater than solids because particles in liquids move freely and have greater space between them when compared to particles of solid. Observe the image which shows the arrangement of particles in solids, liquids and gases. Look here. In solids, the particles are closely packed. In liquid, the distance between the particles is more than the solids. And here in a gas, the distance between the particles is very, very high. Once again, observe the arrangement of particles in solids, liquids and gases. The distance between the particles of gases is much more than solids and liquids. That's why the diffusion is very, very higher in gases. In a gas, the particles are not as close together as in a liquid. This happens faster in gas than in a liquid because of large gaps between the particles of gas.